Europe sailed to the west coast of Africa, exchanging freight for slaves, then set sail for the Americas, where the slaves were exchanged for sugar, tobacco, and other products. The slaves' living quarters were often a deck within the ship that had less than 5 feet of headroom. With 300 to 400 people packed in a tiny area, an area with little ventilation nor space to place buckets for human waste, disease and death was prevalent. Once arriving in the Americas, the slaves were branded with red-hot irons and put in shackles. Slave owners were afraid of rebellion and forbade their slaves to use drums because they were able to communicate with each other. To say the least, this was an embarrassing time in U.S. history when many Americans thought it right to oppress and abuse an entire race of people. However, we can point to any time in human history where slavery was practiced and see how the oppressed people used music to help them persevere, heal, and survive. This time of slavery in America from early 1600 until 1865 is no different. African Americans used many songs for both spiritual and hidden meanings. Follow the Drinking Gourd is one such song that contained directions for runaway slaves to follow the North Star from Alabama and Louisiana north across the Ohio and onto Lake Erie in Canada. Wade in the Water was another spiritual that contained secret messages. Harriet Tubman was the chief organizer of the Underground Railroad, which sought to covertly help southern slaves escape to freedom in the north. She instituted this spiritual as a warning to runaway slaves to abandon the path and move into the water. By traveling along the water's edge or across a body of water, the slaves would throw chasing dogs and their keepers off their scent.